As an anthropologist, discussing the subject of religion is actually a critical component of the entire phylogenous matrix that gives birth to human culture of today. There's nowhere in any of your social institutions that there are not clear homages and reflections, the ancestral cultural DNA, if you will, of religion. You cannot avoid it in any of your social institutions. You can't avoid it in any of your philosophies. You can't avoid it no matter what people do to create any kind of new paradigm or new way of being. People are people, and culture is culture, and how we do our thing has come from somewhere that we know about. And it's very clear. It's not just in our history, it's in our prehistory. It's all throughout the whole thing. So when you say, for example, that science and religion are not two things that are compatible for study, you're absolutely wrong about this. And from an anthropological perspective, to ignore religion is complete folly. Complete folly to study cultural anthropology without studying religion as well. Because there is no culture without religion. Religion and culture are the same, just as is art. High culture comes when people begin to make more than what is there. That is how we have come so far. That is the evolution of all of our ideas, all of our knowledge, all of our science. Science is the evolution of religion. And science is for the purpose of knowing yourselves. It's for the purpose of understanding who you are in the world and what you're supposed to do with yourselves. How can you solve your problems in this world? What keys are there? What patterns can you see? This is a mathematical process. It's not mystical. It's not mumbo jumbo. It's not left to the worst people who only make up lies and just want more money. You can't pin it all on them and leave it to them. If you pin it to them and leave it to them, they will do that. You have to come to them. You have to say, this is a generative, evolutionary process. We have to adapt. We have to change. We have to grow. We have to be more than we were. We have to be less in some way. We have to find where to trim, and we have to find where to come up. We need to find what needs to be done and do that. Just do that. Very clearly, all of the problems of the world, anthropologically, the J curve, the demographic transition, the environmental devastation, the displacement of people, the international diasporas, hundreds of millions of displaced people migrating all the time, war, pestilence, disease, famine. All of these things are spreading and growing. Desertification, the acidity of the oceans. All of this is a problem, and all of it is critically linked to the activities of human beings. We know this is true. Fact that you people are destroying the planet. How can you fix it? This is a religious question. It is a question of your superstructure. It is a question of your worldview. It is a question of your beliefs. It is a question of how you do mathematics. It's a question of what you think of the world as dualist, non-dualist. Is it a straight line? Is it all curved, empty space? Do things have points, or is everything the same? Is everything all one, or is everything just nothing? Is it the same thing? What do you think? You have to! This is critical for us to study. Critical for us to study these things. It's critical for you to study these things. Why would you not study these things? How do you expect to solve the problem without using the tools at your disposal? How did you come to this position? Where did it come from? Where does it need to go from here? This is what you have to ask.